Well, hello, Crossroad Kids, and welcome to another Sunday Home Connection. Pastor Lynn here, and as you can see, we've got a new theme for this month. It is called Indescribable, because your Creator has no limits. Well, you know, you may have heard that saying before, the sky's the limit. Well, guess what? God is our ultimate limit, and He is vast and big. And because He is a creative God, He creates us in His own image to be creative too. So as you guessed it, all month long, it's about creativity. Well, creativity is imagining what you can do because you are made in the image of God. Well, one of my favorite ways to see God's creativity is in all the amazing animals that He has created. So I thought I would test your listening skills to see how well you know your animal sounds. So here's what we're gonna do. I'll play an animal sound, and then I'll put a few options up on the screen, and then I want you to yell out really loud which animal you think matches the sound that you hear. Are you ready? Here we go. Is that sound a dog, a bear, a fish, or a sheep? Well, if you guessed sheep, you are right. I know you're so smart. All right, let's try another one. Is that sound a cat, a shark, an owl, or a cricket? Well, if you guessed an owl, clap three times. Great job, my friends. All right, are you ready for your next sound? I have to warn you, they will get a little bit harder. Here we go. Is that sound a leopard, a frog, a bald eagle, or a spider? Well, if you guessed frog, you got that one right too. All right, moving right along. Is that sound a whale, a snake, an elephant, or a walrus? Well, if you guessed whale on that one, give me a really cool, oh yeah. Good job. All right, here's our last one, and I have to say, it's my favorite. Is that sound an otter, an alligator, a mountain lion, or a hippo? Well, believe it or not, that sound was an alligator. Who'd have thought? Snap three times if you got that one right. Good job, my friends. Well, today we're gonna go back to the basics, back to the very beginning, the book of Genesis, and we're gonna learn all about creation. Because if you want to know and see evidence that our God is a creative God, just look at the world around us, from the bright, brilliant sun in the sky to the moon and the stars, right down to the tiny, tiny little ant that works really hard. From you, me, we're also evidence of God's creativity. You know what, my friends? It's gonna be a great day. Oh, and one more thing before we get started. Fun day, Crossroad Kids, fun day. That's right, it is August 14th. Here at the church, I want to see you there. I've already sent out the information to your moms and dads, so tell them to be sure to register you. It's gonna be so much fun. All right, you know what to do. Press pause, go grab your Bibles, meet me right back here. We're gonna get our worship on, hear our story, and then we're also gonna hear who won last week's weekly challenge on drawing heaven. See you in a bit, my friends.
Thank you. do you see when you look in the mirror? Your best silly face? The school picture day smile? That look you get when mom tells you to get out of bed for school? Whatever you may see in the mirror, something amazing is true. You are a mirror. God made you in His very own image to reflect who He is to the world around you. That's right. When people look at you, they can see a little piece of what God is like. Not the way your mouth is shaped or the color of your eyes, but when you choose to encourage someone, "Hey, great job today." Others can see God's kindness. When you paint a picture, they catch a glimpse of a God who imagined the whole world. When you help your friend solve an argument, they can see a reflection of the God who made peace with us. The God who thought up the entire universe made you to look like Him. And when you use your imagination, you can show the whole world a little piece of what He's like. That's why creativity is an amazing way to worship God with your life. Because worship is about more than just singing loud. It's all about living loud.
Our story starts with the very first verse of the very first chapter of the very first book of the Bible, Genesis chapter 1, verse 1. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The earth didn't have any shape. There was darkness over the surface of the waves. The Spirit of God was hovering over the waters. God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. God saw that the light was good. He separated the light from the darkness and called the light day and the darkness night. How's that for a beginning? And that was just day one. On the second day, God made the sky. God said, "Let there be a huge space between the waters." And that's exactly what happened. And God called the huge space sky. That was day two. but it was the next day when God's creativity really took root. God said, "Let the water under the sky be gathered into one place. Let the dry ground appear." God called the dry ground land. Then God said, "Let the land produce plants," and trees and plants and flowers sprung out of the ground. And God saw that it was good. That closes the book on day 3, but God wasn't finished. He had a whole sky to fill. God said, "Let there be lights in the huge space of the sky." And so the stars were created. And then God made the moon to rule over the night. He made the sun to rule over the day. And God saw that it was good. Day 4, boom, sun, moon, and stars. Without them, we wouldn't know what time of day it was. Think about that. Okay, stop thinking. Things are about to get wild. God said, "Let the seas be filled with living things." So God created every kind of living thing that fills the oceans. And God said, "Let birds fly above the earth across the huge space of the sky." And then God created every kind of bird that flies. And God saw that it was good. That was the 5th day. But it was the 6th day when God made his masterpiece. And I'm not talking about the platypus. God said, "Let the land produce every kind of animal, cows, horses, chickens, bugs, snakes, mice, rhinoceroses, orangutans, platypi," and it was all good. And then God said, wait for it, "Let us make human beings." Watch out, world, here we come. So God created human beings in his own likeness. He created them as male and female. And God told them to take care of the earth and all that was in it. This was day 6. On the 7th day, God rested from all his work. But before he did that, he took a good look at everything he had created, and he saw that it was very good. The end.
Never have to wonder if somebody cares for me.
I love the Maker. And the Maker loves me. Yes, he does. He loves you and he loves me. He loves all of us. And here's a really cool thing. Because God is a creative God, we get to share a little bit of who he is in everything that we do each and every day. That's pretty cool, I think. And speaking of creativity, if you remember last week, I put out the challenge to be able to imagine what you think heaven looks like and to draw a picture. Well, our winners for that challenge are Cole, Brayland, and Evie. You can expect a gift card in the mail this week. Great job, my friends. All right, well, that wraps up another Sunday Home Connections. As always, I love you and I'm praying for you. And remember all week long that your God has no limits. He is indescribable and he has given us an amazing world to live in. So go and enjoy it. Be sure to also register for our Crossroad Kids Fun Day, Friday, August 14th. It's coming up. Tell your moms and dads. I want to see you here. All right, I love you, my friends. Have a great week. See you next time.